Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing roughly 10 autumn outfits with you. Could be more, hopefully not less. These are going to be outfits that I think you will see me wearing a lot over the next couple of months, and I've got some new pieces mixed with some old pieces. There's one outfit in particular which I'm putting in this video, which I'm pretty sure I've put in like two previous like autumn winter videos now, but it is an absolute staple until the point where I wear it so much that I hate it. It's going to continue to be in these videos. We've got a mixture of items which you can use for like wearing around the house, or you can dress up if you are able to go out, but definitely lots of pieces that could be worn more casually or more at home and on comfy days. So hopefully there's a little bit of something for everyone in this video, and I hope you guys like it. Let's get started with what I'm wearing now, and trust me, you're gonna love this. You're gonna die for this, I know it, but let's hope it's in stock by the time you see this. So outfit number one consists of this And Other Stories midi dress, which I love so much. It's this beautiful like warm gray color. It's kind of like an off-whitey gray. I love it. It's not too gray, not too cool toned. It is the softest midi dress. It's almost a maxi dress for me, but it's meant to be a midi dress. It's the softest thing I've ever owned. Like, I am in love with it. It has a gorgeous tie waist kind of feature, like it really wraps around, so you've got a little bit of a wrap skirt, and that makes it a little bit sexy, and that's something that I love so much. I don't love it when midi dresses just kind of like swamp me. I always have to belt them, and even then I feel a little bit like I have to really work to make it work, but I love this so much. It's so snuggly, it's so soft, perfect for when you're at home, or I can pop on like a low pair of like sandals with it, you know, like the little kitten heel sandals, which you guys know I love so much. I could pop those on with this and just feel super nice and dressy, like ready for a dinner during the autumn. I'm talking a lot with my hands today, let's just deal with that. Have lobster hands right now. I've paired it with my Zara fluffy Birkenstocks right now, just to kind of show you how it can look on a more casual basis. But you could also pair it with a nice pair of like ankle boots and a leather jacket if you want to dress it up just a little bit, and I'll show you that now. So I've paired my midi dress with my Topshop snake print boots, which I have had for I think about 3 years now. I will try and put dupes for everything in the info box below for you guys. I actually started pairing this with a pair of chunky boots for this video. I actually didn't like it at all, which is funny because a lot of my midi dresses I wear with a chunky boot, but it just didn't work for this one in particular. I feel like because of the wrap style of it, it's a little bit more feminine, and that just lends it slightly more towards like a nice streamlining ankle boot. And I've just paired it with my little Givenchy bag. This is new if you haven't seen her already, and I just think this works so nicely. It's like a gorgeous off-whitey gray, just like this. This is kind of like an oatmeal-y color coming up on camera, but this viewfinder does me dirty all the time. I describe colors from the viewfinder and then I'm looking at the edit and I'm like, doesn't look anything like that. So yeah, to me in real life this is kind of like a beigey toned kind of gray. I love it. I love it so much. And I think these pair really nicely together. And because it's a grey snake print boot, I feel like everything ties in really nicely as well and has a little bit of texture and pattern in it. I just love this look. It would also work really beautifully with a pair of very simple like white trainers. But yeah, this is outfit number one. I love it. I love it so much. So look number two is a look that I personally love. I feel like it's definitely a Marmite outfit, and it's also going to be slightly controversial in terms of temperature for autumn. But autumn across the board in various different countries is very, very different temperature wise. And I have a global audience, so I'm kind of trying to cater for a lot of you in these outfits. This is something that I could definitely get away with wearing at the moment. I'm filming this in the last week of September in the UK. I know for some of you in warmer climates, this will be like an autumn, late autumn, like winter outfit for you. So those of you that live in cold countries, remember with this one, it might not be for you right now. It might be for a very warm autumn day. But I also do understand that for some of you, like my winter clothing is your like early autumn clothing. So take this with a pinch of salt. I'm gonna let you know which climate I consider each outfit for. But for those of us in the UK, we're also not going anywhere. So you can wear this inside. But yeah, I love this outfit. I'm not sure everyone will. I know not everyone loves an oversized blazer. Like, I love an oversized blazer. I really love them. So I paired my Zara kind of co-ord, it's like cycle shorts and a little gray top with a blazer and then my chunky boots, basically just casualing the blazer down like as much as possible. You know, lots of us aren't able to work in offices at the moment. We're not really going places too much, but we still want to get use out of the blazers in our wardrobe that we just haven't had a chance to wear. This outfit here in the UK will also work really, really beautifully with a pair of leggings, high-waisted jeans, that kind of vibe. Just switch out the bottom half and you're good to go. But yeah, I love this outfit. It's a little bit edgy, a little bit smart, but casual underneath for when you like get home and you just want to strip off and take off all your clothing and just be comfy. You don't actually have to get changed into a whole new outfit. Or if you're going anywhere where you just want to be comfy once you've taken your jacket off, but you want to look like good before you get to your destination, this is a great outfit. Like I said, makes use of the blazers in our wardrobe that we're just not really getting to wear as much as usual right now, but also makes use of some of the really comfy clothing we have bought during lockdown and want to continue getting the wear out of going forwards. The sunlight outside is actually blinding me, sorry if there's any weird lighting on my face. But yeah, let me know what you think. I feel like this is going to be a Marmite outfit, judging from the last video a couple of weeks back where I wore an oversized blazer and there were just some people that were like, I'm just not a fan of an oversized blazer. I absolutely love it. If you get an oversized blazer as well that is long enough, they can also double as a dress. So it's basically like two outfits in one. I love it. So yeah, just to recap on where everything is from, the blazer is from Zara. The co-ord is from Zara. The boots are from Zara. Bag is your. But yeah, also if you're in a warmer climate right now, let me know. Have I got it? Have I hit the nail on the head? Because it's really hard to judge other people's autumns, you know? And here is just a little example of how you can take the same cycle shorts and top and make it a lot more casual. This is like a perfect at-home autumn outfit. And I feel like this works for a lot of people across the board, because when we're at home, you don't have to worry about the elements and the weather outside. I literally gravitate on a daily basis towards cycle shorts and just like a sandal for if I like need to do stuff in my garden, if I need to literally like run down the road to a shop. This is like a go-to kind of outfit for me. Got a chunky cardigan, which by the way, you guys need to get acquainted with this chunky cardigan, because if you love my mango one and you wanted a dupe, this one is so great. The only difference between this and my mango cardigan is the kind of overall knit of it is not as tightly knitted. So my mango one is actually a very like loosely knitted cardigan. Because of that, it like hangs, like it really like weighs itself down and hangs, and it has also worn very quickly, so it always looks super disheveled. It didn't actually look that disheveled when I bought it, but that's just the way it's gone with a very loose weave. Whereas a lot of cardigans on the high street are actually more of a like tight knit, so they don't lose their shape as quickly, which I would actually say is a pro. I think most people would appreciate that. But it has really similar buttons, a really similar kind of like lining down the side. So I got this in a small. If you want it sized more like my mango one, I would go for a medium or a large, size up depending on what you need. I think on me, a medium would be very, very similar to my mango cardigan. So if you guys want a good dupe, this is a very good dupe. There is also a very good dupe on, nearly broke my nail. There's also a very good dupe on Zara as well. But I love this one. It's such a lovely color, a very like warm, light oatmeal-y color, really, really beautiful. Works really nicely with this very kind of like soft gray color of the Zara co-ord. And then I've just paired it with my Zara like sheepskinny, sheep's woolly kind of, I don't know, what do you call this? Fluffy Birkenstocks. Let's go with that, fluffy Birkenstocks. I think the cream tone of these goes really nicely with the cardigan. And this is an outfit that you would catch me wearing if you just kind of like walked into my house and caught me off guard. I'd probably be wearing something like this, because I'm an actual grandma when you guys aren't around, like seriously. Okay, so the oversized blazer has had its moment, it's out the way, the cycle shorts are gone as well, and I don't think they're returning for this video. So those of you that just hate the kind of like active weary sports luxe vibe can just like sit comfortably now. This next outfit is a personal like favorite of mine, like potentially an all-time favorite. Lots of you will know I love a shirt jacket. Like I love a shirt jacket, and I have for a really long time now. We've had various different shirt jacket moments throughout my channel. We've had the white leather one, still own all of these shirt jackets because I am obsessed. The white leather one, which I would pair with trainers. The brown one, which I actually had a cowboy boots moment with and will wear with cowboy boots. And I would also wear with like heels, and I'd wear both of the shirt jackets with like my snake print ankle boots as well. Like, am I still allowed to wear snake print ankle boots? Are they still a trend? Is it still okay that I'm still in love with them? after like 3 years, I don't know. But an ankle boot always works really nicely with a shirt jacket. You can pair it with jeans, or if you're smaller like me, you can take full advantage of the fact that jackets basically look like dresses and roll with that, which is what you are about to see. You can also wear these with cycle shorts now. I feel like we've got to a point in fashion with cycle shorts where they are like widely accepted as like a legitimate item of clothing, like a legitimate item of fashion clothing now. So you could wear a shirt jacket with cycle shorts underneath, or a cute pair of trainers and a chunky boot, that kind of vibe. Thank God cycle shorts are just like, everyone is wearing them now, because it just means that I can go ham with it. But I'm not wearing cycle shorts with this today. I'm just taking full advantage of the fact that I am 5'2" and jackets work as dresses on me. I know there'll be a lot of you that can't relate, but this is where leggings come in so handy. Like, you can get a nice pair of leather leggings, throw them on under this, it'll work so well. A nice pair of black skinny jeans, this would look amazing. You can even stick with the same pair of shoes, or you can make like me and just wear a pair of shorts underneath. I'm actually wearing like a pair of Nuin, like very short sports shorts, but it just means that I am so like covered underneath this. I don't feel like I could just like flash someone at any time. But going into winter, be rest assured that I will also be wearing this with leggings and jeans along with everybody else. Ooh. Again, nearly knocked my lamp over. That happened in the last video. I need to just step forward slightly. But anyway, the shirt jacket is from Zara. Hopefully it's still in stock by the time you guys watch this. It has come in and out of stock like several times over the past month. I'm kind of waiting for the black one to come back in stock because I feel like I need it. Can someone let me know? Do I need it? The boots are also from Zara. I really love these. They might not be for everybody, but if you like the top half of this outfit, you can kind of work it with whatever you want on the bottom half. You could go for a nice pair of knee-high boots. You could go for a nice pair of chunky boots, trainers, ankle boots, like you name it. This is so versatile. That's why I love shirt jackets so much. So both of these are from Zara. And then to pair with the outfit, I just got for my little black Givenchy bag in the shiny leather, because I think it works really nicely with the shiny boots as well. Right, okay, hear me out with this next one, because I know things are looking a little bit dressy right now, but I'm going to show you how you can take last year's slip dresses, like your evening slip dresses or silky midi skirts, either works for this, and make them an autumnal outfit that you will actually get the chance to wear this year. You know, it's not really looking like party season. It's gonna be a thing over here, and I love to still get the use out of like key items in my wardrobe. And this is one of those. It's one that I love so much because it works so perfectly for an evening event. It is absolutely beautiful. I love this. I've had this in my wardrobe for, I think, 2 years now. Some of you may have seen the outfit that I'm about to create before, because I've showed it in quite a few like what I wore in a week videos. And I think I also featured this in a spring styling video as well, because if you love an all black outfit like me, this works for spring as well. This basically works every season other than summer. So I'm so here for this. This is just like the perfect item for me to have in my wardrobe that can literally take me from like casual to like dinner to like fancy, you know. If you want to recreate the end look of this, but you don't have an evening dress, or you're just not interested in dresses of this vibe, you can also use a black, like silky, it doesn't have to be silky, but I just like the texture that it gives. A black kind of midi skirt with a slit in it. The slit for me is kind of vital, but not necessarily for everyone. This one is actually from Zara this year, so if it is still in stock, I will link it, but I'm sure places like ASOS and Topshop have plenty of items like this. This dress in particular was actually from Topshop 2 years ago now, so if you wanna go and try and pick it up on like Depop or somewhere, that is where it's from. But I'm just popping a belt on with this, which looks crazy. It just looks absolutely ridiculous, I think. But then I grab a nice like black slouchy knit, but I then pull the majority of the dress up, because this dress is quite long on me, so hopefully you can see this. I pull it up, not too high. I try and avoid my tattoos being seen. There was one point where I was like pulling it up super, super high, but just pull it up a little bit, just so that the slit kind of sits at a nice point on my thigh, because it normally sits somewhere around my knee. Short girl problems. It also covers up the belt a little bit, and that's when I know I'm kind of there. And then I take my black slouchy knit. This is from Zara. Shock. And then take the hem of it and tuck it in to my belt. You make sure the belt can't be seen. It sits like at my waist point, so like the smallest point. And then we have this little kind of like crop jumper situation. All Saints actually do a dress, which is like a dress with a jumper layered over like this, and I didn't realize until this time last year, and I was like, oh my god, I've been making this outfit, and how funny All Saints actually like produce this outfit, but in like a one, it's all connected, and I just thought that was amazing. So if you can't be arsed with the faff, All Saints actually do this. This is what it looks like once you are done. I usually leave the back untucked. I kind of think it looks nice like that, but you could also tuck the back as well if you wanted it to be a little bit more fitted looking, if that makes sense. I'm not super fussed. I like the fact that it looks really slouchy and the jumper really casuals down the dress. And then for the shoes with this look, you literally have your pick of the bunch. I've worn it with trainers, chunky boots, ankle boots, heels. This would work with the fluffy Birkenstocks. Anything goes with this outfit, and that's one of the things that I love so much about it. I've paired it at the moment with my And Other Stories boots. I believe they brought these back this year. I love it when brands do that. It is just the best. It's got a nice big chunky heel. I love the color of these as well. It's so autumnal, so gorgeous. And these boots work really nicely with any dress that has a slit in the side, because you kind of still get a bit of leg even though you're very, very covered. This is it with the chunky boots. So as you can see, it's just a slightly more tough kind of vibe. I really love this. I love it with the chunky boot. Then we have our fluffy sandal if you want to just like look nice at home and get the wear out of your slip dresses or midi skirts. And then finally we have a little low heel just in case you're going out for a dinner and you want to kind of be like that dressy cash. I think this is so perfect, and this outfit works really, really well with the leather jacket, which I feel like is an item that the majority of us have in our wardrobes. So with that in mind, I'm pretty certain that we can crown this the perfect autumnal outfit that literally works for whatever occasion. My work here is done. Just kidding, we've got like 10 more outfits. So this next outfit is less of the comfy cozy, more of the I'm trying to look presentable kind of vibe for whatever you need. I don't like to assume that every single person is home and just like chilling on the couch in their loungewear. So my shirt's from Topshop. Those of you who have been following me for a little while might remember this. This is an outfit that I loved. I think around January time, January 2020, this was like such a vibe for me. I've got my Topshop shirt. This one is like super long at the back. It's got like a split side. Works really beautifully if you're wearing skinnies and heels, which is really nice, but I feel like we're all not gravitating towards wearing heels right now. Let me know if you disagree. We'd love to know. But I paired it with my Zara leather look leggings and my chunky boots, and then I've just gone for a nice big bag. If this is more of a dinner situation, then you could go for a smaller bag, maybe in a white or a neutral or a little black bag. But I threw on the tote with this because I think it just makes a nice smart casual work outfit. Obviously not if you have to like wear a suit for anything or anything like that. I'm really not great at doing like corporate dress codes. I did work in corporate for a little bit, but I worked in marketing and the vibe there was completely different to the shocking vibe there was completely different to the rest of the company. If I had been working in the finance department or HR, it would have been fully suited and, you know, all of that. But yeah, marketing was basically wear a nice pair of trousers and a nice top that doesn't show your arms or knees, I believe, and no flip-flops, and you were good to go. So do bear with me here, but I feel like for some work environments, if you do have to go to work for whatever reason, this would be a really lovely one, or it's a nice back to work outfit when you're eventually allowed back in the office. But yeah, also just works day to day as like if you're going out for a dinner or a nice lunch or something like that, and you want to wear something that is smart but really, really comfy, like the leggings are just a dream. No heel on the boots, so really lovely and comfy, and the shirt is just like super oversized, so it's going to hide a food baby really, really well. So for the next few outfits, we're about to move into the kind of like cooler temperatures. The outfits that for me, being in the south of the UK, I'll get the wear out of more towards like the mid and end of autumn. For some of you, this might be the kind of outfits that you're wearing right now, and for some of you, these might be outfits that you're wearing like 2-3 months time, or just never wear because it's just too warm where you are. But I'm starting off with an outfit that is kind of quite basic, and then I'm gonna build from here. So we have my Zara leather look leggings once again. I've also paired it with a kind of cable knit style. This is a very classic cable knit style jumper. This is from And Other Stories. I believe I got this in a medium. I will correct myself if I'm wrong. I do believe I sized up in this, and it's actually not particularly oversized at all. So I would say this actually does run quite small because this is me sizing up. So yeah, I was expecting it to be a little bit more oversized than this, but it does mean it lends itself quite well towards being worn underneath other items. When you get an oversized jumper, it's sometimes really hard to wear a coat over the top of it unless your coat is super oversized too, and then you basically just look like a giant fluffy marshmallow walking down the street. So this kind of does work out for me quite well for this outfit in particular. I have added a little bit of a twist in terms of the shoe. Normally I would just throw my Zara chunky ankle boots on, which you've seen a number of times in this video already, but I paired it with the knee-high lace-up boots from Zara. I think it actually adds a really nice, like, little interesting twist to this outfit that could be very, very basic and that we've all seen on me a lot before. Jumper, leather look leggings, chunky ankle boot. So this works nicely on its own for more casual occasions, on warmer autumn days where you want to be a little bit snuggly but you don't need like the whole coat, the whole shebang. And what I also like to do with this outfit is throw on my All Saints, like a big chunky oversized scarf with the All Saints logoing across it. You can kind of wear it like bunched up like this. I think that's really nice, really cute. Throw it over your shoulder, that kind of vibe. But you can also wear this more as like a cape, and I really like that. With this outfit in particular, I love that because you've got the mix of the cable knit texture, you've then got the logoing on the scarf, we've got the leather look leggings, and then also the lace up boots as well. It just turns into a very interesting outfit very quickly with very little work, and I love that. So this kind of vibe is an example of how you can build an extra layer over a very, very simple outfit. And then as things get even colder, we can throw on a black aviator jacket. This one is from Zara. If you've watched my Zara haul, you'll be familiar with a lot of the items in this video. If you haven't watched the Zara haul, I will link it in the top corner of the screen for you guys. But this one is one I picked up recently. The quality of it is incredible. I am obsessed. And if you want to as well, you can also add the scarf on top. It's just a little bit bulky for me. I love this outfit, and this coat in particular is an absolute winner for me. I really do feel that aviator jackets work really well throughout the autumn winter season. They're very versatile. They can work for more dressy occasions, but also very, very casual occasions and everything in between. So yeah, definitely a staple to add into your autumn and winter wardrobe. They also work really nicely with like scarves, beanie hats, gloves, that kind of thing. They're just that perfect like in between of like a dressy or casual coat, you know? So yeah, love this one. So if you throw your hair back into a low ponytail and add some like cat eye sunglasses with this one, you've got yourself a very Hailey Bieber type outfit. This is one that those of you that have been subscribed to me for quite a while will have seen me wearing. Definitely last year, I literally lived in leggings, this All Saints hoodie, and then this mango coat again. They actually have something very similar to this. A couple of bits are quite similar to this actually, again this year, so I will link them for you guys. By the way, sorry if my lighting has gone super janky, but it is like now pouring down with rain. It has gone from like glorious sunshine to like actual torrential rain. That is autumn. But anyway, this outfit is just one of my absolute favorites of the past year. It's so comfy, so easy. It doesn't look like you're dressing super casually, but you are, and you are so comfortable. It also works really nicely with a pair of trainers as well, and you can really throw whatever bag you want with this. I've just literally picked up the black Givenchy because it works nicely with the black outfit underneath the camel coat. You could do like a black backpack just slung over one shoulder. A tote bag would work with this. Literally anything, but the more casual really the better. What I love about this is even when you take the coat off, the outfit still doesn't look too casual because it's all one tone, it's all black, so it's just not really drawing attention to the fact that you haven't made any effort at all. I also think leather look leggings are just the perfect way to make it look like you've made an effort when you haven't. And the addition of the boot with the leather look leggings just kind of makes it look really, really pulled together. The camel coat then just helps to elevate it slightly. It looks a little bit more expensive than it, definitely more expensive than it is. It's one of the best high street purchases I think I've ever made in my life because I've worn it so much for like three years in a row now. It's honestly one of the most worn items in my wardrobe, and I live for it. But it all just works together really nicely as a perfect like autumn winter outfit. You can add more layers to this as well if you want, if it's super cold. So like scarf, hat, gloves, that kind of vibe. If it gets super cold for me, thermals go underneath the hoodie, and thermal leggings can go underneath the leggings. For those of you that live in places like New York, which just gets so much colder than it ever does in my winters here. Anyway, winter's a completely different topic, and you'll have a completely different video for that. So we'll stick to talking about autumn for now, because winter scares me. I'll just stay home. I will just stay home. No winter video. Nothing. But yeah, I love this outfit. You guys know, you've seen me in it a lot over the past 3 years. So yeah, that is outfit number, I've lost count. I show you so many variations of things that I actually do lose count, and that's why I start off with like 1, 2, 3 and then I've lost it. Let me know, do you count if I like switch bits up in an outfit? Do you count that as a new outfit? Do you count it as the same? Would love to know. Okay, hopefully I'm gonna fit on screen because I'm wearing a heel, guys. When I say a heel, don't worry, it's not a dressy heel. This outfit is one that I just love. This encapsulates, is that the word? This is just everything about autumn that I love. We've got leather trousers, my croc leather boots, which I just love so much. I got these from ASOS last year and I love them so, so much. And I refuse to not wear them this autumn. I refuse to not get the wear out of them. So even though they are a more dressy item, really, in my everyday wardrobe, they'll definitely be getting worn on more like special occasions, dinners, lunches, that kind of thing. Occasions when I leave the house and want to look nice, this is gonna be such a go-to outfit. This jumper as well.
It is the most beautiful autumnal color. I love it. Oh,
This is from H&M. If it's still in stock, I will link it. I know it's definitely still in stock. It keeps popping up for me on Instagram in the light kind of like beigey color. So I will link what I can for you guys. But yeah, I just love the combination of the very autumnal colored knit, the leather trousers, the boot. This is just like everything about autumn in an outfit. And then I've just paired it with my little Fendi camera bag. It's like a little crossbody, so it's nice and easy. This definitely helps the outfit then look like it's lending itself more to a casual situation. If I went for a dressier bag, this outfit would definitely start to look a little bit dressier. This is, we're going into winter with a really simple, maybe like tie waist black coat will work so perfectly, but for autumn, for now, this is so fine. And you can definitely layer things underneath this if you are one of those people that gets very cold very easily. It's definitely one of my tricks to autumnal dressing and stringing, because autumnal dressing is one of the best like styles that there is, but we only have a small window that we normally get to wear them. So my number one tip for stringing it out as long as possible is thermal leggings, or just leggings in general underneath like your trousers will help make you so much warmer. Vest underneath your jumpers, thermal long sleeve jumpers underneath your jumpers, honestly works a treat. I've only ever done one New York Fashion Week, and trust me, that completely saved me. But yeah, this is just the most gorgeous autumn outfit. I really love it. So this final outfit is an adaptation of a long time favorite of mine. I used to have a long black knitted, well not a long, that's actually completely incorrect, a knitted jumper from Zara that was very long to the point where it was a dress on me. And I loved it so much. I used to wear it all the time with this coat and then with my Topshop snake print boots. It was a go-to outfit for me, especially during the transitional summer to autumn season. It was so perfect for going out for dinner and drinks in the evening where it just really wasn't that cold yet. It was perfect. And then as it got colder, I would throw either a leather jacket, like a big oversized leather jacket, or this jacket on over the top. That jumper, sadly, I shrunk. I got my hands on a tumble dryer in my last apartment. It came with a tumble dryer and I was super excited to start tumble drying everything. Don't do that. Don't do it. Anyway, I learned my lesson because the jumper got shrunk. It was so sad. It started to get holes in it as well. So it was like long past its sell-by date, really. I've worn it so much. I've washed it so much. It had just not survived. So I've been looking for a new version for the longest time, and Topshop have provided, some of you might have seen me wearing this already on my Instagram. It's got a higher neck than my old Zara one, but I actually don't mind that. It looks a little bit more dressy. And once again, I've paired it with my Mango coat, but I've actually switched up the shoes just to give an old favorite look of mine a new lease of life. I've paired it with the knee-high lace-up Zara boots, and I think it just adds like a more current twist and works really nicely with my current style as well. Also works really well to the current climate. I'm more likely to be wearing like a flat casual boot and just looking a little bit more casual than I am dressy. But we're still sticking with the coat and Fendi bag, which were an absolute staple for me back when I used to wear this outfit all the time. And if it does get a bit warm and the coat is not needed, the outfit works really, really beautifully on its own as well. I also kind of prefer this Topshop one because not only do I prefer the high neck, it's a little bit longer in terms of leg length as well, which I think works well for me, but also works well for so many people who are obviously much, much smaller than me. So I feel like this one is a real winner. And depending on how you like to style things, this could also be worn with like a pair of leather leggings, just a normal plain pair of leggings, skinny jeans. It would look really, really gorgeous in that way as well. Or if you're a tights kind of girl, this will work really well with tights too. I know this is something that my mum in particular would really, really love to wear with leather leggings and then like a nice pair of UGG boots or something like that. So I feel like this one is a real crowd pleaser and could just work with so many different styles. So hopefully it's still in stock, and if it is, I will link it in the info box for you guys. But yeah, that is my final outfit. And I have a lot of mess to clean up. A lot of mess. Baby Nala has made her bed on the All Saints scarf. So just a little side note, if you are a viewer from a much cooler climate and actually none of these outfits are going to work for you and your temperature at the moment, don't worry, because very, very soon, sooner than I've ever done on YouTube before, I will be back with my winter, autumn to winter transitional outfits, and then we'll be moving into winter outfits very, very soon. The puffer coats will be coming back out. I am so excited. I hope you guys are too. And I hope you've enjoyed this video and enjoyed seeing what I'm going to be wearing basically over the next couple of months. Let me know which look was your favorite in the comments, and I will see you guys again very, very soon. Bye.